Hi, I'm Daniel from Forward Audio, and in this video I'm going to show you how to do proper phase alignment for electric guitars. So on the last episode we've already talked about setting up the microphones. This time we're going to focus on the proper phase alignment to get a full and vibrant sound. Let's recall what we already have. So on this recording we have a Shure SM57 as a bright mic, a Shure SM7B as a dark mic, the DI track, and an Audio Technica 804050 as a room mic. Let's start with the close mics. The SM57 is almost as close as it gets to the grill, whereas the SM7B has about 30 centimeters of distance. We should therefore expect phase issues, or better, a time difference between these mics. To demonstrate to you how this changes the sound, I've run white noise instead of a guitar signal through the cabinet. As soon as we add both microphones together, we get serious phase cancellations, resulting in the so-called comp filter effect. Besides of these problems with cancelling frequencies, there's another problem which is also very important but only rarely mentioned: the effect on the transients. When mixing both signals together, short peaks in the signal don't add up correctly, as you can see here. Only if the mics are time aligned properly, they add up, resulting in a peak amplitude that is much bigger. This effect can be described as transient splitting. That sometimes even goes so far that in order to preserve the transients correctly, you have to use subsample precision. From a limiter plugin, you may already know the term intersample peaks. The same effect occurs in phase alignment when there are peaks in between two samples. Then we need to measure and align the subsample precision in order to preserve the maximum peak. Now, a lot of engineers still think that the only way to avoid these kind of time alignment issues is to move the mics around. So what do I mean by that? That means that you arrange the mics in a way so that their membranes have the same distance to the cabinet. Our SM57 has its membrane right here at the label, and the SM7B has its membrane at this position. If I place both in this manner, there's no time difference between the mics and therefore no phase cancellations. Although this technique works technically, it also has a major drawback that it strictly limits the placement of your microphones. And also, for some microphone types, it's even hard to know where the membrane is placed exactly. So you put a lot of time and effort in getting the distance right. An alternative with much less hassle is to time align these microphones in your DAW instead of physically. Theoretically, you could move around the regions of the tracks and try to align them on site. And I know some engineers who do that. With this method, you have the drawbacks that you can only do it after you've recorded the track and not during recording. And it's also sometimes hard to work on site and to be precise at the same time. Furthermore, it's impossible to work subsample precise within your DAW. The easiest method to align these tracks is, in my opinion, with automatic time alignment plugins. And that's also the reason why I put so much time and effort in building this company and delivering this kind of plugins to you. During this tutorial, I will show you how to use FA Guitar Line, which is specialized for this purpose. Now, I know a lot of you guys are just starting out and can't afford these kind of plugins, so I will also show you how to achieve at least somewhat similar results with our free plugin FA Sample Delay. The low budget way to time align these microphones is to measure the distance between the membranes with a tape measure. So we firstly measure the distance of the SM57 to the grill, then the same with the SM7B, and calculate the difference. After that, we insert FA Sample Delay into the track which is closer to the speaker and delay the signal with a measured amount. If we want to do the same with FA Guitar Line, we just have to route these tracks to a stereo bus, pan them left and right, and hit the Align button. One of the many benefits of FA Guitar Line is that you can do this during setup too. When you are setting up your microphones, you usually don't just throw them in front of a cabinet. You carefully check how each of them sounds, and then you also need to know how they sound together when already phase aligned. So every time you move one mic a little bit, you can align them again within seconds without the need to measure anything. With FA sample delay or FA time align, you have to adjust this manually every time you change something. With this time alignment technique, we now have complete freedom of movement. Instead of restricting our possible mic positions to a two-dimensional plane, we can now move into the third dimension. This is a real game changer, and a little bit like comparing GTA 1 to GTA 5. Both can be fun, but with a newer one, you have a third dimension and a lot more possibilities. My claim is, when working with closed mics on a guitar cabinet, you can achieve perfect phase and time alignment only with aligning the delay instead of moving mics around or doing anything else. In some tutorials that are out there, you will hear that you can use the phase switch to deal with phase issues. I've already made a video claiming that this is not working as you would expect. But just for fun, let's see how this affects our guitar recording. The only thing we can achieve is that we can shift the cancelling frequencies up to a higher level. You will hear this often, that you should simply try with a phase switch and without it, and take the version that appears to have more low end. In reality, by doing that, you only shift this notch a little higher. Using the polarity switch to solve these kind of issues was the only solution back in the analog days. But today, we have much better tools for this kind of issues at our disposal.
So does that mean that the phase switch is completely useless, Daniel?
No, there are some situations in which the phase switch, or better, the polarity switch, is absolutely necessary. For example, if you place a microphone behind your cabinet, which is sometimes done for combos and cabinets with an open back. If you place the mic on different sides of the speaker, every time the membrane moves out, this mic will get a positive amplitude and this one gets a negative. So as a general rule, when placing the mics in front of the speakers, you can leave the polarity as it is. If they are behind the speaker, you have to flip the polarity, but you also have to compensate the delay as well. And there are other situations related to wrong wiring in which you should use the polarity switch. This pair of Octava MK012 microphones, for example, is differently wired internally. Somehow, these both pins are swept. So every time I use these together with other mics, I have to flip the polarity, otherwise the results are devastating. Wiring issues can also occur if you somehow have a mic cable that someone soldered wrong. In that case, you should either resolder the cable or at least mark it. There's also a small possibility that the speaker wires in your cabinets are swept if someone tampered with it or replaced the speaker. In this case, you should definitely resolve the issue in the cabinet and not with a polarity switch, as this issue also has acoustical side effects. Let's proceed with aligning the DI signal. When recording clean or crunchy guitars, I often use the dry signal and mix it with the microphone tracks. The DI signal usually has a better representation of a transient and a tight attack. If we use an automatic phase alignment plugin like FA Guitar Align, we can simply add another bus, send the already mixed mics to it, and do the phase alignment the same way we already know, and the plugin does everything needed for us. If we do manual alignment with FA sample delay or FA time align, we have a problem. With the mics, we could simply measure the right distance, but the right delay between DI and the mics can't be measured. Your best chance is to firstly move the regions on side and then make some fine adjustments with a plugin. The last track we have to align is our room mic, which is 6.5 meters away from the cabinet.
But wait, Daniel, why do we need to phase align room mics, for heaven's sake?
That's true. Room microphones don't have to be perfectly aligned to the other tracks. But nevertheless, we can change their delay in a more creative way to change the room perception of a microphone at our will. So theoretically, we could alter the room impression in two ways. We could shift the room mic to an earlier point than our mics, or perfectly align them, which results in a very flat room sound. We could also shift the room mic a little back or even further away in the future, so that the room appears bigger. This is kind of similar to changing the pre-delay value on a reverb plugin. Let's hear how this sounds in comparison. Please note that this trick doesn't change the room information itself, but the pre-delay is an important indicator of room size to our ear. So to give you just a quick impression on what other effects are used for this guitar sound, for the DI track, I've did a fair amount of EQing and added a transient designer to even further shape the attack and reduce the release of a DI. On the guitar bass, I've only added a low cut and a subtle boost in the mids, and also a little bit of compression. And that's all. If you carefully do your mic placement, phase alignment, and mic blending, you can already achieve a good natural sound without the need for further processing. One last quick tip. If you want to apply an EQ to your single tracks, as I did on the DI track, I recommend to use a linear phase EQ with a low latency setting. A normal equalizer introduces slight frequency-dependent delays, which interfere with our time alignment. If all tracks are already mixed together like an our guitar bass, you can safely apply a normal EQ. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Let me know your opinion in the comments below, and also be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell. Thanks for watching.